Hello and welcome to Bollywood Bala. I am Sonu. Today we will be discussing and debating about GST, that is goods and service tax, that will be implemented in India from the 1st of July 2017. It is being touted as the biggest tax reform in India, but it has got Bollywood a whole lot concerned. Let's try and understand from Himesh and Ritesh if this concern of Bollywood and other bigwigs from the world of the film industry is valid or not. Himesh, let me begin with you.
Yep.
Do you think there is cause of worry for Bollywood as far as GST goes?
See, I think this is a very good move for the industry, for the film industry, because currently the rate of tax which is imposed on Bollywood films on an average pan India is approximately 40%. That is 40% on the net collections.
Okay.
And after GST,
that is the entertainment tax.
That is the entertainment tax. That is 40%. So if, like, for Dangal, I was talking to someone, for Dangal the net collections are 384, whereas the gross is 512, which is 40% higher. But after GST it will be 28%. So we are straight away getting benefit of 12% from GST. And I think what the Bollywood people have been talking about is they were expecting 10% or 5%, which in my opinion is unreasonable in a sense, because expecting such a big fall in such a short span is not justifiable. It will happen eventually, but right now this is a good thing for the industry because that will boost the collection. And another thing about this is GST would make sense if the theater owners decide to pass on the benefit to the audiences.
Okay, the consumers.
But okay, if that doesn't happen, then it is pointless, basically, if that doesn't happen.
No, but you know, in terms of when we talk about entertainment tax, it is different for different states. Like,
yeah,
Delhi has about 20%. In Maharashtra, it's about 45%.
Maharashtra is 46%.
45-46%. Yeah. Bihar has something else.
60. Bihar is 60. Yeah.
So, of course, it will benefit a few states. It will not benefit a few states. So, but as far as Bollywood goes, you find it beneficial?
In totality,
no,
it is beneficial.
Bollywood in Maharashtra would be beneficial. Hindi films in Maharashtra.
Bollywood in many states, like Maharashtra would be beneficial. UP will be beneficial. Bihar would be beneficial. Then Jharkhand. You won't believe that entertainment tax rate in Jharkhand is 110%.
Okay.
So, so although it is a small territory, but it is 110%, which is too high, and it will straight away drop to 28%.
Okay.
So, see, it is beneficial in major territories, but in some small territories, say like even in Delhi, it is 25, it will rise to 28, which is 3%. So,
okay, so that is negligible.
Yeah. And Mumbai is the biggest territory where currently it is 46% and it will come down to 28%, and which is the biggest territory as far as in Bollywood
films Hindi films are concerned.
Yeah.
Ritesh, aapka kya raay hai is baare mein? 28% hoga GST, to jo entertainment tax hum abhi pay karte hain, kya aapko lagta hai ki 28% se fayda hoga consumers ko? Ye kya dekhte hain?
Ji, mera simple sa logic ye hai ki agar ye tax lagta hai तो फिल्म इंडस्ट्री का जो बिजनेस प्रोस्पेक्टिव ये बढ़ा के दिखाते हैं, जो चीज़ें 100 करोड़ 200 करोड़ हो सकता है, उस पर भी असर आए, क्योंकि इनको सीधा मेन पैसा दिखाना होगा कि सारे टैक्स काट के डायरेक्टली एक टैक्स लगता है.
ओके ओके.
बट सुनो बिनो, आई टेल यू वन मोर थिंग. राइट नाउ आई थिंक बॉलीवुड इज द ओनली फिल्म इंडस्ट्री वेयर वी गिव नेट कलेक्शंस. इफ दिस इज द इंटरनेशनल फिल्म इंडस्ट्री, साउथ इंडियन फिल्म इंडस्ट्री, एवरीवेयर दे आर गिविंग द कलेक्शंस इन ग्रॉस. But Bollywood is giving it net because of various reasons, different tax rate and everything.
No, that is okay. But see, when we talk about, see, what is GST is, the consumer will be taxed for the goods and services that will be consuming, right? So, if you look at it, I think Mukesh Bhatt certainly makes logic when he says that it is akin to equating it with gambling and other betting services. So don't you think he's right in that sense? When you're saying 28% and you equate that with the gambling and betting services, that is not what the film industry is all about.
Yeah, of course. See, he has a point. But, you know, Sonu, we need a strong representative from the industry itself. This issue.
So you mean these guys are not?
No, see, you need a face value for media coverage. If Aamir Khan or a Salman Khan or a Shahrukh Khan speaks, that would grab the headlines and that would put on more. See, there is
more
Akshay
pressure.
Kumar and everyone. But if a Siddharth Rao Kapoor or Mukesh Bhatt, they speak without any backing from the stars, it wouldn't have that impact. So we need to have that unity first to propose something to the government. If we don't have that unity, the government would of course take us for granted.
So simply put, let's say if a big film is releasing in Mumbai, like let's say a Tube Light comes up, okay? So in that case, we will only have 28% tax to be paid regardless of the price of the ticket. How do you look at it? I mean, in layman's terms, can you please explain this?
See, Tube Light, first of all, Tube Light won't be coming under GST because of reason. But if we have to take the
example...
I'm
just giving an example. Yeah.
So see, basically right now, we are paying 100 rupees for a ticket. Mm. 100 rupees is the admission cost. If you see the ticket, it is divided into two parts, the admission cost and the taxes. So right now we are paying 100 as admission cost,
okay,
and over and above that 40 as entertainment tax.
Okay.
45 in Mumbai.
45 in Mumbai, correct.
So after GST, we'll have to pay 100 plus 20 if the theatre owners decide to pass on the benefit to us.
But if they don't decide,
then they will be selling the ticket at 140 itself.
Okay.
And the entertainment tax would be somewhere, sorry, and the tax, the cost of the ticket would be the same, but the taxation amount would be somewhere like admission fees would be increased from.
But 100. Then what tax would be there?
No, exactly. Tax would be 28%.
Okay.
But the theatre owners might increase the admission rates on which the tax is imposed to a higher amount.
Mm-hmm.
So it depends on the theatre owner if they decide to pass on the benefit to us or not. And see, another thing is the producers are talking as if they have to pay the tax. But that's not true, the tax. It is an indirect tax.
Correct,
so the consumers
are
paying it.
They are worried about the consumers, right? So if there
if they would have been worried about the consumers, they won't. See, if there is a film releasing, the producers have a lot of say on the ticket rates of the theatres.
Right.
They wouldn't force the theatres to charge ticket at XYZ amount.
Yeah,
yeah,
I agree to that.
Yeah, they are doing that because, you know, if the tax rates are reduced further, they would get more money. And knowing the industry, I'm very sure they won't pass on the benefit to us.
Right. आप इनके बात से सहमत है कि यार एक सिद्धार्थ रॉय कपूर से ज़्यादा एक सलमान खान या ऐसे व्यक्ति को आना चाहिए इस मुद्दे पे बात करने के लिए प्रेशर डालने के लिए?
पूरी तरह सहमत हूँ, क्योंकि जब एक चेहरा सामने आता है, जैसे आप देख सकते हैं, जब चेहरा बात करता है तो मीडिया भी सुनता है और पब्लिक भी सुनती है। जब तक इस चीज़ को स्टार प्रमोट नहीं करेंगे तब तक इसका कोई फ़ायदा नहीं करता। एक बात और मैं इसमें जोड़ना चाहूँगा कि करप्शन से छुटकारा मिल सकता है। जो करप्शन, कई टैक्सेस लगाए जाते थे कस्टमर को, और जो टिकट रेट्स 500, 600, 700 रुपए के वीकेंड्स पे बेचे जाते थे, हो सकता है, ये मैंने कंप्लीटली बोल सकता हूँ, हो सकता है कि एक फिक्स अमाउंट टिकट्स का भी हो जाए।
ओके, हिमेश, यू नो व्हाट, रीजनल फिल्म्स इन महाराष्ट्र, इन गुजरात आर टैक्स फ्री, सो व्हाट विल हैपन टू दोस फिल्म्स?
या एग्जैक्टली, दे सी, देयर इज अ पॉजिटिव एज वेल एज अ नेगेटिव। फॉर बॉलीवुड आई थिंक GST इज अ वेरी गुड मूवी because the net collection would increase and like we discussed. But for regional films, in Maharashtra it is 0%, Gujarat it is 0%, in Tamil and Telugu films, the UA rated films, are tax free, whereas the UA rated films are taxed at 15%.
Correct.
So even there they will have to pay 13%
yes.
more tax. So
but no, what about Marathi films?
Even Marathi films will have to pay taxes. They are tax free in Mumbai right now.
They are tax free in Mumbai right now.
They are tax free, but exactly.
So that's not a good move then.
For regional film industry, the
Because the regional audience are also as multiplex as probably Hindi film audience are. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. So for regional film industry, this is a very bad decision. So I think there have been protests down south to remove GST for regional films. Let's see what happens. In south, if you see, there have been many big names which have come forward to talk about this. And this center is actually considering their request for cutting down the tax rate, at least for the regional films.
So I think perhaps Siddharth Roy Kapoor and Mukesh Bhatt are also talking in general about India at large.
Yeah, they are talking
taking
about India.
Taking in consideration not just Hindi films, but also regional
films. Yeah, and for regional films, this is not a good thing. Not at all. Like.
Okay. So what could be done then? Because regional films are burgeoning right now.
एक और reason है महेश भट्ट के बात करने का, क्योंकि वो कभी भी बहुत बड़े बजट की फिल्में नहीं बनाते हैं, तो उनको इस बात का साफ साफ डर है कि उनकी बिजनेस पे बहुत बड़ा इफेक्ट आ सकता है, इस वजह से वो इस चीज़ का साथ दे रहे हैं। साथ ही साथ सिद्धार्थ कपूर भी कुछ इसी ट्रैक पे चलते हैं, क्योंकि वो इंडिविजुअल प्रोड्यूसर नहीं किसी फिल्म की।
बट अगेन दे आर परहैप्स वरीड अबाउट हाउ देयर फिल्म्स विल फेयर इन द रीजनल मार्केट, लाइक हाउ दिस लाइक व्हाट इट टेक्स टाइम।
नो, हिंदी फिल्म्स, if a Hindi film releases in Tamil Nadu,
okay,
that won't be a tax fee. That would be tax, like there are different tax slabs in different.
No, correct. That would be taxed, right? Yes.
Yeah.
So of course, in a region where perhaps tax is not as much as it is right now, with 28% coming in, if it is on the higher side, then perhaps those films will be affected. No?
Yeah, of course. Overall the impact. See, there is benefit. The GST tax slab is beneficial in some states. It is not beneficial in some states. But like I said, the overall impact of this, the pan-India impact, it is beneficial by approximately 10-12%.
How will Bollywood benefit? How will the film industry benefit?
See, right now, first of all, to add on to what Ritesh was saying about the face value, if you remember in 2009, you had seen Shah Rukh, Aamir and everyone coming together for the first time for the some issues related to multiplex, and that was resolved because it was a Shah Rukh Khan and Aamir Khan speaking.
Mm-hmm.
But right now the government is not speaking, the stars are not speaking to the government. And as far as the second question is,
they are not bothered.
Yeah.
No, I think they will probably come because most of them are producers in any case.
Maybe.
They may come out later on, maybe. But yeah, you're continuing.
Yeah, and about the benefit to Bollywood, see, right now the collections are divided into two parts, that is net collection, net box office collection, and gross box office collection. What is reported in the media is the net box office collection, which is gross minus the taxes. So with 20, right now the tax slab is 40%. If it is 28%, automatically the net collections will increase proportionately. So right now, say if a Dangal has earned 384 crore, if it comes under the GST slab, it would automatically earn the same everything being constant, only the change in the tax rate, the total collection of Dangal would be around 420 crores, which is around 40 crore higher.
Achha, okay.
Right. Likewise, a Bajrangi, I had done the calculation.
But how is that possible? If it is 20 and not 45 in Mumbai?
No. It is not about Mumbai. Right? It is about the overall thing. See, if it is 40% right now.
Okay.
So if the tax rate is reduced, the admission fees would increase.
Right.
If the admission fees increase,
right,
the net collection would increase.
Achha. Okay.
If the net collection increase, yeah. So exactly. So if the tax is reduced, automatically the impact would be on the net collections.
Right.
Which would so you can't.
So finally, do you see ticket rates coming down or going up? I don't think so.
I think it will remain constant. The theater owners will benefit, the producers will benefit, but the audiences will suffer.
So,
until and unless they surprise us by reducing the ticket.
So I think we will have to wait and watch how this actually turns plays out.
सरकार को भी कुछ कदम उठाने चाहिए जिससे आम जनता को भी फायदा हो. सबसे बड़ी चीज मनोरंजन लोगों को खुश करने के लिए होता, तो हम चाहेंगे सरकार से आग्रह भी है कि सिर्फ प्रोड्यूसर डायरेक्टर्स और उन लोगों को फायदा ना पहुंचाएं, आम जनता को भी फायदा पहुंचाए.
एंड एट फर्स्ट तो आई थिंक टैक्सेस होने नहीं चाहिए. व्हाई शुड वी पे टू गेट एंटरटेनमेंट?
या
व्हाई शुड वी पे टू गेट? देयर इज नो टैक्स इन US फॉर एंटरटेनमेंट, देयर इज नो टैक्स इन चाइना फॉर एंटरटेनमेंट, इट इज ओनली इन इंडिया. And so now if you see the overall revenue of government from taxes is around 1 lakh crore from overall all the taxes. And entertainment industry ka contribution in those taxes barely, the total collections in a year are around 4000 crore, uska 40% ja raha hai, to 1000 crore contribution. 1000 crore agar government ko nahi mila to kuch nahi hota.
Okay.
Example ke through isko brief karna chahunga aam janta ke liye. Ye ek choti si cheez hai ki jab aap money transfer karne jate hain kisi ke account mein, तो कभी कभी 2000 लगाने पे 30 रुपये एक्स्ट्रा लगते हैं, 40 रुपये एक्स्ट्रा लगते हैं. कभी कभी आप अगर उसको पैसे नहीं देंगे तो उसी 2000 में से इनबिल्ट वो काट लेते हैं, आपके खाते में 1970 रुपये ही जाते हैं. तो हम चाहेंगे सरकार से कि इस तरह का कोई सिस्टम रखे, टैक्स को पूरी तरह से हटा दे.
ओके.
और जो पैसा दिया जा रहा है उसी में से सिनेमा ओनर से बोला जाए कि वो सरकार को टैक्स दे.
ओके. ऑलराइट. सो फाइनली इट्स बीन अ ग्रेट डिस्कशन. जस्ट टू सम इट अप, वी डोंट हैव एनी रीजन टू बी कंसर्न, number one. And if at all Siddharth Roy Kapoor or Mukesh Bhatt wants things to change, they should perhaps get more bankable names like superstars.
Yep,
if they want their concern to reach,
yep,
the concerned ears in the government. Alright, thank you very much Himesh, and thank you very much Ritesh, and thank you very much for watching Bollywood Wala. Keep tuned to my channel for more discussions and debates from the world of Bollywood. Thank you so much. Bye.